The colon and the rectum is the end of your digestive system. So we eat, it goes down our esophagus, stomach, small intestine, and the last part of your digestive system is your colon and your rectum. It's where we do some absorption of nutrients as well as absorb water. Colon and rectal cancer is the fourth most common cancer diagnosed in the United States. There's on average about 150,000 people per year diagnosed with the disease. About two-thirds of the time it's in the colon. The rectum is the last 4 inches or so of the colon, and that has about a third of the patients who are diagnosed with colorectal cancer. So most people who are diagnosed with colorectal cancer have what's called an adenocarcinoma. Adenocarcinomas are cancers of glandular tissue, and so that's the majority of type. There are other types of colon cancer, small cell, occasionally lymphomas, carcinoid, but the vast majority are adenocarcinomas. The first thing for patients to know is it is a treatable disease, and for a lot of patients it's a curable disease. It's particularly curable if it's caught early, which is why colonoscopies for screening are so important, to try to catch either before a patient even develops disease with a polyp or to catch it early. The second is it is a team approach for both colon and rectal, but particularly for rectal cancer, where there are different treatments that may be employed to help cure patients as well as treat patients of the disease. So for colon cancer, the primary treatment is surgery if it hasn't shown evidence of spread to other parts of the body at the time of diagnosis. Patients who don't have spread of disease at the time of diagnosis will have surgery. And then depending what's found, and the things that are particularly important is how deep through the bowel wall it goes and whether there are any lymph nodes involved, will determine whether they need further therapy, particularly chemotherapy. For patients with rectal cancer caught very early, they may go to surgery first. And depending what's found, they may also then need chemotherapy and radiation after, or they may just have surgery alone. For patients who present with disease already spread, then it's a decision regarding surgery upfront or starting with chemotherapy. In terms of surgery, probably the advance that's occurred has been in two forms. One is laparoscopic surgery, which has been done for years for various conditions and been employed for colon and rectal cancer for at least a decade, but now there's actual studies that show that it's not only as good as open surgery, but it has some benefits in terms of shorter hospitalizations, improvement in time of pain and bowel restoration. So for a lot of patients, laparoscopic surgery is appropriate both for colon and rectal cancer, as long as with a surgeon that has expertise and as long as their cancer is amenable to that. There are some people who will still need an open surgery. For rectal cancers, there's also been advancements with a more defined surgery where it's a more sharp dissection of the tumor, cutting it out, that allows it to have a decreased risk of recurring in the rectal area. For chemotherapy, both there's been some advances in earlier stage disease, so now we employ three drugs as adjuvant chemotherapy after surgery to try to reduce the risk of recurrence. And for later stage disease, there's really been strides in terms of having increasing options for patients, both in terms of number of drugs and sequencing of drugs that have doubled the median survival in the past decade for patients with metastatic colorectal cancer. There's also been advances in terms of patients with metastatic disease, some of them undergoing surgery for their metastases and having curative effect. In terms of what's coming in the horizon, what we're learning more is that there are certain subtypes of colorectal cancer based on mutations that can help select certain therapies. Unfortunately, we still have a long ways to go in terms of knowing which is the right therapy for which patients and how best to target, as opposed to some other cancers where there's now multiple targeted therapies depending on the mutation. So I think Cancer.net has a very good resources both for learning about colon and rectal cancer, as well as familial syndromes, things that people may inherit that increase their risks of colon and rectal cancer to learn more about the disease.